Nichols and McAllister. God, who will that your only begotten Son, having conquered death, should pass over into the realm of heaven, grant, we pray, to your departed servants, that with the immortality of this life overcome, they may gaze eternally on you, their Creator and Redeemer. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
And no torment shall touch them. They seemed in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For in the sight of others indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation they shall shine, and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect.
Oh.
reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. For Christ, while we were still helpless, died at the appointed time for the ungodly. Indeed, only with difficulty does one die for a just person, though perhaps for a good person, one might even find courage to die. But God proves his love for us, in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. How much more then, since we are now justified by his blood, will we be saved through him from the wrath? Indeed, if while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of his Son, how much more, once reconciled, will we be saved by his life? Not only that, but we also boast of God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received reconciliation.
Dominus vobiscum. Sequentia Sancti Evangelii secundum Johannum. Jesus said to the crowds, "Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and I will not reject anyone who comes to me, because I came down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. And this is the will of the one who sent me, that I should not lose anything of what he gave me, but that I should raise it on the last day. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have eternal life, and I shall raise him on the last day." Verbum Domini.
Yesterday we celebrated the wonderful solemnity of All Saints, where we recognize those who are already in glory, seeing the very face of God in his divine presence. We recognize not only the saints that the church has proclaimed, but our relatives, our friends who are in heaven because of God's love for us in giving us Jesus, whose blood saves us from eternal damnation and leads us to heaven. It was a joyous occasion. Today, we celebrate the commemoration of All Souls, which reminds us of the pain of death, not only for those of us who die, but for those of us who grieve. And grieve we do when we lose someone we love. And that's part of death. It's part of healing. It's part of being purified, especially when we commend our departed brothers and sisters to God's purifying judgment, his merciful love, his divine mercy. In today's commemoration of All Souls, with unshakable hope, the Catholic Church prays for all the faithful departed, whose baptismal holiness has been smudged by sin, even forgiven sin. I'd like to share with you three parables about purgatory. The first is a parable about God's justice. God demands justice for our sins and our crimes. There's a story told of a drunken driver who crashed into the automobile of a family of five, killing the mother, paralyzing the father, and severely injuring the children. Afterwards, when he became sober, he realized what he had done. He went to confession, repented, and he even sought the forgiveness of the family. He was given a severe punishment by the state, 25 years in jail, a penance by the priest. At his death and personal judgment, when he came before the face of God and God's purifying, redeeming love, he realized in a most painful way how his forgiven sins continued to harm that family after he was forgiven. Purgatory completed any form of justice that was lacking in his penance on earth. The second parable is about the purification of purgatory, the transforming change we need in order to enter into the total holiness of Almighty God and to be physically and spiritually in his presence. Buzz was a good Catholic. He went to Mass every Sunday and Holy Day of Obligation. He confessed his sins frequently and received absolution and did penance.
But he had many weaknesses that persisted even until the moment of death, habitual sins. He had an eye for beautiful women. He was unfaithful to his wife on several occasions, both in thought and deed. He liked to drink too much, waste money, and often did not give a full day's work for a full day's wage. He was a party boy, and his irresponsibility put his family in debt and caused great tension in his home. When this man experiences his personal judgment at the hour of death before the throne of God, the only way he can be admitted to the fullness of heaven is by being purified of his human weaknesses and propensity to sin. In heaven, men do not lust after women. They have no propensity to sin whatsoever. So something changes, and we are purified by God's grace, his holiness, in order to be in his presence, perfect as he is. We will be in the full communion of all the saints with Jesus Christ, the church triumphant. The third parable about purgatory is about complete reconciliation. The father, who was the victim of the drunk driver, continued to suffer anger and rage toward the man who had killed his wife, injured him and his children. It made him a lifelong paraplegic, and it brought him great anguish and heartache. When this man died, at his personal purification at the judgment seat of God, he was purified of all anger, bitterness, and difficulty in forgiving. He was fully reconciled with the repentant and now saint in heaven who had caused him such pain and heartache, and he loved him now as a brother in Christ, a perfect love. The church's dogma of purgatory is a dogma of profound hope for us poor, miserable sinners in need of purification and to be made perfectly holy by God at our personal judgments. It tells us that God loves us, but also he is a God of justice, and his love is like a purifying fire that makes us perfectly holy for eternity in heaven. As we continue this requiem and enter into that one sacrifice of our Lord in an unbloody way, the blood of Christ that purifies us and makes us holy for eternity, let us pray that we will always commend the faithful departed to God's loving mercy and pray for them in their purification.
Thank you.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. Receive, Lord, in your kindness the sacrificial offering we make for all your servants who sleep in Christ, that set free from the bonds of death by this singular sacrifice, they may merit eternal life through Christ our Lord. Benedictum, abscriptum, ratum, rationabilum, acceptabilumque, facere dignere, ut nobis corpus et sanguinis, fiat delicissimi filii tui, Domini nostri, Jesu Christi. Qui privie, quem patere pur, accipi panem in sanctus adveravus manus suas, elevatis oculis in celum, ad deum patrum sum omnipotentem tibi gratias agens and dixit regi eque discipulis suis dicens. Accipite et manducate ex hoc omnes. Hoc est enim corpus meum, quo pro vobis tradet. Simili modo postquem cenatum est, accipiens et unprequarum calicem in sanctus ac venerabilis manus suas. Icum tibi gratias agens benedictit dedicuit de tripuli suis dicens. Accipite et vivite ex eo omnes, ic est enum calic sanguis mei, novi et eterni testamenti, qui pro vobis et tumultis et undet por impremisionem ec ad coro, hoc accipe in meam commemoration. Mysterium fidei. Offeremus requare maestati tue de tuis donis ac datis, ostium puro, ostium sanctum, ostium immaculatum, panum sanctum vitae eterna, et calicem salutis perpetuae. Supraque propitio ac sereno vultur respicere dignens, et accepta adere secuti accepta adere dignatus est, munera pueri tui, justi abel, et sacrificium patriarchae nostri amem Dominum nostrum amen. Memento ipsium Domine famum famorumque tuarum, qui nos recesserum cum signo fidei, et dormiunt in somno pacis. Ipsis Domine et omnibus in Christo contentibus, locum refrigeri, lucis et pacis ut indulgeas te precamor per Christum Dominum nostrum. Amen. Nobis quoque peccatoribus famulus tuis, te multitudine miserationem tuorum sferentibus, partum aliquem et societatem donaribus, cum tuis sanctis apostolis et martyribus, cum Ioannes, Stephano, Mattia, Barnaba, Ignacio, Alessandro, Marcellino, Pedro, Felicitate, Caprova, Agatha, Lucia, Agneta, Cecilia, Anastasia, et omnibus sanctis tuis intra quorum non consortium, non estimantur meritis et denie quaesus logitur et mite, per Christum Dominum nostrum, per quem ec omnia Domine semper bona creas, sanctificans, vivificans, benedicis et prestas nobis. Er ipsum et cum ipso et in ipso, Escibi Deo Patri Omnipotenti in unitate Spiritus Sancti, omnis honore gloria, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Precepti salutaribus omniti et divina institutione formati, audemus dicere. Ecce agnus Dei, ecce qui tollit peccata mundi. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. a second collection from St. Vincent de Paul Society. Through these sacrificial gifts which we have received, O Lord, bestow on your departed servants your great mercy, and to those you have endowed with the grace of baptism, grant also the fullness of eternal joy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just a few announcements before our commendation and final blessing. Representatives of Family Advancement Ministries are selling tickets to Mark Ballard's Decorating the Holidays event, planned for an entertaining evening to benefit Family Advancement Ministries, which will be held on Tuesday, November 18th. Bless These Hands will be selling fair trade items after Mass in our social hall. The Sacrament of the Anointing of the Sick will be celebrated this Thursday at 11 a.m. Mass, followed by our seniors' luncheon. And I want to thank our choir, under the direction of Nelda Chapman and Harold McManus, our organist, our combined choirs, for working so hard to make this Requiem Mass, Choiré's Requiem, so beautiful for us. Seminary Patrick has one brief announcement before we continue with the commendation.
Just real quick, youth group will be meeting tonight at 6:10 over at St. Joseph's School. The high school will be meeting in their gym, and we will be eating chicken wings, tater tots, and talking about purgatory. So that's tonight at 6:10. Thank you, guys.
And this Mass is also offered for Mildred Neal and Myron Saver and all the faithful departed on our list. We do ask that you remain in place for the final commendation of all the souls in purgatory, as well as for the in paradisium as we depart the church. And then when that is concluded, please depart the church in silence. Trusting in God, we have prayed for the faithful departed, the holy souls in purgatory. Let us pray with confidence to God that he will raise up in holiness and power all the faithful departed and command their souls to be numbered among the blessed. May God grant them a merciful judgment, deliverance from death, and pardon of sin. May God, Christ the Good Shepherd, carry them home to be at peace with the Father. May they rejoice forever in the presence of the eternal King and in the company of all the saints.
Thank you.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend all the faithful departed, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, they will rise with him on the last day. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servants, and help us to remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with the saints in heaven, through Christ our Lord.